afternoon, Dr. Ali, and good afternoon, Ms. Alvapara. I am Mr. Patrick Raymond.
I'm Ganesha Vichandaido.
I'm Saito Pinares.
I'm Tan Kim Kasper.
So today we're going to show you a study on the adaptability potential of Gloveria rubra. So there are many different kinds of species of plants that all have various benefits towards health status of human beings. These plants are often used as treatments of the humans. Some of the common treatment properties are anti-inflammatory, antipyretic, antipyretic, analgesic, and many more. The present study focuses on the genus Gloveria, in which many of its species have said that it has anti-inflammatory, antipyretic, and antipyretic properties. However, there are still gaps in research about the species of Gloveria, and many of its properties have not yet been discerned. There have been studies about the various kinds of properties such as anti-inflammatory and antibacterial properties of Gloveria rubra, flowers, and its leaves. And however, despite all those studies, the anti-pyretic property evaluation of Gloveria rubra has not been yet researched, which leads us to the reason why we represent this study. This study focuses on the anti-pyretic properties of Gloveria rubra. So in this study, we're going to investigate the anti-pyretic potential of the Gloveria rubra flowers to fill in the gap in research on the flower. So the purpose is, first, in order to investigate the anti-pyretic potential of Gloveria rubra flowers. Second is, to compare the scratching behavior of mice that are injected with the treatment and those mice that are not injected with the treatment. So this study is conducted to determine the anti-pyretic properties of Gloveria rubra. The research of this study will benefit the following. First, the future researchers. The result of this study will benefit the future researcher who wish to research a topic similar to the present study. They will be able to use this study as review of related literature to base on. Second is the botanist. The result of the present study will fill the gap in research about different properties of Gloveria rubra. Botanists can now be one study less from completing the list of all medical properties of Gloveria rubra. Next is the teachers. The result of this study will be useful especially to the teachers in biology. It makes them aware about the anti-pyretic properties of Gloveria rubra, and this new discovery can be remembered throughout their everyday life. Last thing is the students. The students will read this research paper, may use it as a base guide or for their future academic purposes. They may also gain information about the anti-pyretic properties of Gloveria rubra.
Next is the research question that leads to this present study. So the question that came up to our minds was, do the Gloveria rubra flowers possess anti-pyretic properties? Regardless of the countless studies about Gloveria rubra that have anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, and antioxidant properties, and many more, this question is what fucked us most, which leads to the present study. So this is our conceptual framework. So these are the possible causes of pruritus or itching, which is inflammation, histamines or allergies, and bacteria. And as we know, itching is a common problem in everyday life. So we have decided to conduct this present study in order to find an alternate way in treating itching.
So first is gathering of Gloveria rubra flowers. The flowers will be bought in a local flower shop.
you would be needing 3 white mice, which would cost 170 pesos each for a total of 510 pesos. The next would be 12 Kalachichi flowers. Each would cost 50 pesos and would total 150 pesos. For the next would be the apparatus. You would be needing 2 beakers, 1 Bunsen burner, 3 containers, 3 graduated cylinder, 1 steering rod, 1 tester rack, belt, test tubes, 1 tongs. And all of these would be supported by the biology department of the University of San Carlos. The next would be the chemicals. You would require 500 milliliters of methanol and 1 liter bottle of water. And for the scrapbook, you would be spending 200 pesos. All of these would be total to 890 pesos. The next would be the timeline. The first time stamp would be on the 10th of February, which will be on Monday. This time, the research group will be meeting and deciding on how we should spend our money, what to do, and how we're going to conduct research. The next will be the 14th of February, which will be the buying of the mice. One of the research members will be buying the mice at a local pet shop, at Piper's Pet Shop, at M. Coico Avenue in Talamba. The next will be the delivery of the white mice to the biology laboratory. One of the members who bought the mice will be sending it to the laboratory, and the mice will be staying there for 2 weeks for the adaptive environment. The next will be the maintenance of the assets. The research group will be visiting the mice to check if it's still going well or how it's going, and it will also be applied on the 6th of February. Next will be on the 1st of March, where one of the group members will be flying. Be buying the Kalachichi flowers at the local flower shop around Cebu. The next will be the 2nd of March, which is a Monday, the experiment day. This time, we will be doing